This is the grade 6 math practice test for TN Ready. Question number 6 on this version. What value of W makes the following equation true? W plus 4 and 1/5 is equal to 13 and 19 20ths. Now, this is a non-calculator section, so this question looks like a total beast. But if we do a little bit of analysis before we begin, we can save ourselves a ton of time. The first thing I'm going to do is look directly at the fractions because they're staring us right in the face, and that's probably the part that's so scary. 1/5 and 19/20. I wonder if there's some way, let's just look at those. I wonder if there's some way we can tell if we nearly need to go deeply into converting these into improper fractions and such. We'll see. The first thing I need to do is get a little bit of a common denominator in here. That'd be super helpful. If I do a multiples list for 5, I have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, da-da-da-da. For 20, I have 20, 40, so on and so forth. The nice thing is, here it is, and here it is. So 20 is the common denominator. I don't need to worry about changing this one. I'm just going to leave it here. Pretty easy, right? For the 5, it's a little bit more complicated. It's 5 times 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to multiply this by 4, and I have to do the same thing to the numerator as well. So 5 times 4 is 20, and 4 times 1 is 4. Now, seems pretty bonkers, doesn't it? It's actually not. All I have to do is tell myself, well, what do I need to do to get from 4 to 19? Like, what's the difference between those two numbers? And when I say difference, I mean subtraction. So there's a couple things that we could do here now that we have it. We could just do 19 minus 4. By the way, the reason why I'm not adding these is because they're on different sides of the equation. If I want to interact between these two things, I'm going to need to do opposite operations. So what I could say is 19 minus 4 is 15, and this becomes 15 over 20. Now, what else could I have done? I could use the count up method, which is simply counting starting at 4, but don't count 1 as 4. So when I go to 5, it becomes 1, and then I just do 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 on my fingers until I get up to 19. Somebody may look over at you while you're counting on your fingers while you're trying to take your test, if that's your strategy, and sort of like, well, what's wrong with you? And your response back in your head, because you can't talk during the test, is, I'm trying to make a good grade on this. What's your problem? Don't worry about them. Just do what you need to do your best. How they think about you is completely irrelevant in that moment. And if you score better than them, you win anyway. So do what you need to do to get there. Anyway, part of this W is going to be 15 20ths. Now, I can reduce this, and I'll talk about that in a bit, but I'm not going to do it now. The nice thing is this 19 over 20 being so much bigger than this means I don't have to worry about fiddling with these numbers to figure out how far apart they are. I'm done adjusting these, and now I can look at 4 and 13. What's the difference? Again, I can use counting up, or I could just use subtraction. And 13 minus 4 is 9. So I put those two pieces together. So if I have 9 and 15 20ths plus 4, and we said this was 4 20ths, right? Well, 9 plus 4 is 13. 15 plus 4 is 19, and I end up with my answer. So this is the part that I need to get to my final answer. And you can put that there. It doesn't say that you have to have it in simplest form. You can leave it just like that. If you would like to simplify, you certainly can. Remember when we did the multiples list for 5? 15 and 20 are both on it, right? So this is 3 out. And this is 4. So I can reduce this to, there's 3 5s and 15 and 4 5s and 20. So I could put 3 4s. You will not need to put the or part in here. You just pick one or the other and use it. If you're in a hurry and you don't feel like going through the reducing part, don't. If you've done it enough, you probably just see it normally and you're just going to do it anyway. So don't take the longer answer because it's longer. I'm just saying. What would have made this question more difficult is if I was trying to get to a number that's actually somehow lower than this. So if this was more than this one, it would be a bit of a bigger mess, and then I would suggest that you would go through and maybe convert them to improper fractions and compare. If the 19 over 20 had been over here, like how do you get to this one, right? Well, I have to borrow out of this, and that's a mess. This one I didn't have to do that, so I'm not going to spend a bunch of hours or a bunch of extra minutes, I should say, showing you longer methodology when I can show you the short version. Again, be smart about it. Am I going from a small number to a big number? Then that means I'm not going to have to borrow. Am I going from a small number to a big number? I don't need to do any sort of regrouping or anything. It works normally. So find your common denominator, see what you have to do to get from one for the other, put that down, and then look at your whole numbers separately and then bring them together. That way you can avoid trying to do, okay, let me do 13 times 20 plus 19, and what do I need to do to get 5 times 4 plus 1, and then I'm going to have to convert that into the same common denominator. A big mess. Save yourself the effort in questions like this and do it more quickly. I think you'll enjoy having to bother with it less than bothering with it more.